and right or left menu where usually I'll display categories. We have to log into the system. BP admin, it's a WordPress based system. No need someone else to know this URL because only you are going to go there. You can log in using your username or using your password. I'm going to or email address. I'm going to log in using the email address of your account. Login. I'm going to open in a new tab, front end of the website. So right click on top on name of your website and click on open link in a new tab. So we have now what users see here and here what you can do into the backend. To access the menu sections, both menu sections, you have to click on appearance. And now you have a sub menu and one of them is named menus. Click on the menus. You can create as many menu as you wish. You can assign this menu to the top level, or you can assign the menu create, so this is top level, or you can assign the menu to the side level. Let's create a menu and give a name, top. Click on a create menu. Now we have to add options to that menu. Let's add all the pages. Privacy, manage, voila. So these are the two menus create automatically, but if you leave the system to automatically do the menu, you cannot alter, you cannot exclude from the top menu specific options, or you cannot add to the top menu specific options. So let's create this menu. So I'm going to add all the pages and click on add to menu. All the pages appear here. I'm not happy to have the privacy policy the first one. Let's move this. So just put the mouse and drag. That's the way you organize. And let's say manage subscription to be the third one. And don't forget to save the menu. The menu, yes, does exist, but we have to assign this menu to a specific area into your website. As you see, if I'm going to the front end and I refresh the page, is nothing changed. It's just the basic initial menu. To assign to a specific location your menu just created, for example, this is a top area, this is a footer area. I'm going to assign here. So to the top section will be assigned top menu and click on a save. It's done. Let's go back. So now we have home, manage subscription, Olala interactive and privacy policy. I'm going to refresh the page. It's not anymore home. So now the menu I create is assigned to the top level. To convince that it's true, I'm going to delete the privacy policy from here and save the menu and refresh the page. Privacy policy should not be anymore on the top level. It's not. I'm going back. I wish to have the privacy policy, however, and click and add and save. What I need more, by default when someone opened the website, the system is open with the last entry, last post I published to the system. Into this menu I have no way to access this one except I click on a logo. Some people miss to click on logo, just don't know that if they click on logo they are taken to the home page. So I'm going to create a new entry into the menu named home. How you create this one? Just right here, the URL, copy the URL from the main website. Okay, go to this one and into this one, create a custom link. So into this area, I'm going to copy the link, I give a name, home, and add to the menu. Here it is, home. I can change the name of the home if I want to. I can put home one, home that is not relevant. It's up to you what the name you're giving to that option. And don't forget, save the menu. Let's go to the front page. It's here, home. But I'm not happy to have the home at the end. Let's change the position. So take the home and put it here. Save the menu. Let's check it how it is. The home is on the top. Let's show you more tricks so I can what you can do with the menu. I want to organize the menu on a two level. So the single things I have to do to organize the two level is just to drag on a right and release. It's going. And I want this one to be as well on this one. So at this point under Olara Interactive, I'll have manage subscription and privacy policy. Save the menu. Go to the front end, see how it looks like. Only two options. Click on it, I have submenu. You can create three levels. It's exactly up to you, but my advice is to keep everything on one level, keep it simple because you have not too many options on top of the menu. And going back to the menu, and put them back on the first level. You have to have fun with them to stay on the first level, so I'm going to move like this and save the menu. Why is so important to keep on one level? Because this website is optimized for a mobile device. So if you have too many levels for the menu, will be and too many options on the top menu will be a big mess and the website will be read on a small device. Just I'm going to resize the window, so just simulate a small computer. You see, so the menu it's organizing like this. It will be on a many levels, at that point we'll just jump out of the screen. Even the website is optimized for the mobile because actually your content will be not optimized for mobile. So try and keep it simple. If you have any other options you want to put on multiple levels or create many categories, at that point please organize everything into this area on a category level on a side of your website. Let's create now and assign a menu to organize the category or to organize the menu on a side of your website. So this menu is fine, I'm happy, leave it as it is. So this is the top menu. Let's organize another menu and name this one categories. The title is not relevant. The title is just you to know what menu is that one and create a menu. Now into this menu I want to put my category and to organize them in a specific order. So you can put into this menu anything you wish, including pages, but pages are on top, so we leave them there. We are going now to the categories. And I select all the categories and to appear. And add to menu. And newsletter, all along newsletter and to be the first one. I like the order. You can change the order anytime. The same like it was with the top menu. And save menu. That's perfect. So we have now the menu. But as you remember, the menu does not appear as long as I'm not going to assign to the site. I have to go to another area named widgets. You have many widgets. As I told you initially when I present the bizconnection.com.au, this is an extremely powerful WordPress website, full customized, optimized for search engine and for mobile devices. As long as you do not understand what is into this area, just leave it as it is and just follow my instruction just now. When you begin to get used with all this stuff, at that point begin to have fun, because you basically can make your website more dynamic and more friendly to users, but you have to know exactly what you are doing. For any issue, just let us know and we can make a backup of your website, and after that we restore in case you fail with your try to make a better system. So now I'm going to assign the category menu to the right side. You see, I have a banner, another banner, a category, newsletter, subscription. If I'm going to the front end, I took only four of them. I have one banner, second banner and category, and after that subscription. And after that is coming another banner. So the way I'm organizing the widget in the backend on a side, in the same way they appear on a front end on a side. To be able to put my category menu I just created, I just take the category out from here because it's by default. I cannot do anything with that category, it's from the system. And as everything is saved, so take care once you drag out or in something into the site, your change is done automatically by the system, without saving, without click any button save. I'm going to the front end to see that at this point I have no more category on a site. It's gone. We go back. Now I want to put my custom menu on a site under the banner. To do this, I must look for custom menu and drag under the second banner. Here it is. Ask me what I have to display into this one. And I'm going to select the menu name category. I just created a menu with this name before and I give a name. I can give a name categories, or I can give a name main point, or it's not relevant from functionality what name you are giving. It's very relevant for people who see that menu to tell them what exactly contains their menu. I'm going to name the same category and save the menu. Let's go back, refresh the page, and now I have the category under this one. The difference between this initial category and this one is that into this one I can display exactly what I want in the order I want. Let's move this one on top of in between the banners. It's no need to save something when you add or remove component from the side menu, but it's compulsory when you make a change into any options on this area to click on a save button. So the change you are doing inside the component must be saved to be able to reflect into the website. How to move this one? It's just the same, drag and drop. I'm going to move the category menu in between banner and banner. No need to save, because I changed the order of a component, not content of a component. And now I have a banner, category, the second banner. Honestly, it's much better now, so I'm going to leave as it is. To make a summary, to be able to organize your options menu inside the menu, you must use this menu options. Into this menu options, you can create as many menu as you wish and organize item inside the menu. I'm going to create now to show you that you can display multiple custom menu on the left side, and this menu can contain anything actually. I'm going to create another menu and I'm going to name this menu test, because it's just a test for you, and create the menu. And I'm going to put in this menu three options. One of them will be privacy policy, add to menu. The second one will be from category, newsletter, add to menu. And the third one, now watch it, I'm going to add a link direct to my website, one of my business website. So I'm going to create a custom links and name. I'm going to send this one to FastInfo. Name FastInfo and add to menu. So my menu is named test. This is the order I want to appear. If I don't like the order, just drag the items. Even I can do this. Not relevant. Save the menu. Go to widgets and I'm going to put this test on very top, because I want to show you to be obvious. So again, take another custom menu. I can add as many custom menu as I wish. I name this one test one. I choose to be display menu name test and I save the menu. And if I'm going to the front end of the website and I click this one, this is the menu. So you can create menu with links to your website, to your products too. It's extremely flexible, the system. I'm going back to the system. I'm not happy to have this one here, so I just remove options from here, just take out and leave it to go away from the site, and it's gone. So this is all about organizing menu. Thank you very much.